Buumba Malambo is a 24-year-old dynamic humanitarian and child literacy activist. She is a social work graduate from the University of Zambia who launched the BuumbaLambo Foundation at age 16. She is the youngest serving member of the Ministry of Gender and Child National Coordinating Committee in Zambia. Buumba's work has attracted 12 international awards and 2 Zambian specific awards. Hi there, my name is Rose Sibisi. Welcome to Life with Roses. On set today, I have Buumba Malambo. Buumba is the founder of BuumbaLambo Foundation, which envisions an illiteracy-free society for children in need. I'm going to let you hear more about her story in our chat today. So, Buumba, welcome to Life with
Thank
Roses.
Thank you so much for having me.
Tell me about your name, Buumba. What does it mean?
Well, Buumba in Tonga means mercy.
Okay.
It also means grace.
Okay.
And I was given this name because my parents lost their firstborn. So it's kind of, you kind of say they have Buumba. They can kind of have misery. So that's what it means. But in other tribes, it means different things. Like in Bemba, it means creating. In other tribes, I don't know, but that's what I know.
Yes, I'm Bemba, by the way. So Buumba, it's exactly that. It means building. And I'm not surprised that this is the path that you have chosen because you've chosen a path that seeks to build others. And we're going to hear more about that as we chat today. Are you really 24?
Yes. Yes,
no.
I am.
Because when I was reading your bio, there's no way. 24-year-old and you've achieved so much. It's like somebody who has worked decades. Tell us something. What is it that triggered this desire to launch the BuumbaLambo Foundation?
Firstly, for every individual, that is something that I really, really believe in. There's a passion, there's a calling, there's a reason why you're on earth. And some people are lucky that they find their path when they're really young. Like we have young singers, we have young dancers that are really exceptionally so well. So for me also, I just kind of got this calling, the love for people, the love for the poor. And God kept sending me these kind of people, even before I even thought of trying to make a charity. I always had people coming at my house, at my parents' house, seeking help and wanting to do. And I would really love those people and I would sit with them, chat with them. So it's a calling. Really.
If you're only 20-something now and you say you were chatting with people, how far back was that that you were chatting with all these people?
14.
14? Your foundation, I know, was launched when you were about 16.
Yes.
But I'm sure then before you reached that, it's not something that you just woke up one day and said, I'm going to launch a foundation tomorrow. At what point in your life did you realize that there was this desire of the gift to be unleashed from you?
At the point when I saw how other classmates suffered and they would come to school without eating for days, you know. And then somehow people find it easy to confide in me. So I had all these people telling me, we haven't eaten, we haven't. And I also had my story, you know. I would also go with lemons, I would go with things to sell at school so that I could help my parents. And I thought, if I can feel like this and my parents, at least they work, how about my friend who's coming from Kawama and I could see them without shoes, at least I had shoes. So it kind of, it was always in my mind. It was always in my mind. What about that person? What about that person?
Okay.
So because a gift, a passion can haunt you. And it can haunt you to a point where you really have to start doing it.
Okay.
If you're a singer and you don't sing for 2 days, you just feel horrible. So if I don't help people for like 2 days, I was feeling kind of empty.
Yeah.
So that's how I realized that this was my gift. And I didn't know that you can make a charity actually.
Yeah.
So by 15, I was volunteering when I became conscious that there are actually organizations that help people.
We'll get into that. But what I find interesting is that it could go either way, but you chose the very thing that you felt you were deprived of from when you were very young. You had this deep desire to get a good education. And even when you had an opportunity to do so, instead of running for it and focusing on yourself and say, I'm going to get this education, you decided I'm going to invest in others. Mm-hmm. And you started very young. So I find that very commendable. So I would just like us to know more about the BuumbaLambo Foundation. What is it that inspired you to actually put that together? Because you could have easily said, I'm just going to help my neighbor and support them in their school education journey, or I'm just going to help two other people. Why would you go so big?
When I went to UNZA, the University of Zambia,
okay.
I went there because there was somebody who believed in me, and they believed in my gift of intelligence.
Okay.
They believed in the ability that I'm a girl and I can do something with education.
Yeah.
And then we were taken to for field work in Chanyanya village. And what I saw was really horrible. And it came back to me with the way my life was, what I went through, and what I've been seeing over the years.
I'm so excited to hear more about the BuumbaLambo Foundation. But before that, let's take a quick break. Welcome back to Life with Roses. On set today, I'm speaking to Buumba Malambo. And before the break, we were just getting into finding out more about the BuumbaLambo Foundation. Buumba, what inspired you to start the foundation?
What inspired me, firstly, is God, because He's the one who gives a gift and a passion.
Mm-hmm.
And He directed me to my gift. He was showing me all these signs. And when I was at UNZA, we went to some village for catchment process.
Okay.
And because I was doing social work, I was doing a degree in social work. So we went to this village, and there were those four little girls that used to follow me every day, and they would watch me read. They would watch me on the laptop, and they were really curious. And they used to ask me questions like, so you're in school? And I would say, yes, I'm in school. And actually, UNZA, this is how it looks. And I could see that they wanted to learn, but they just didn't have the chance.
So there was a need.
There was a need to learn.
Okay.
Yeah.
And it got established in the village. You didn't go out in the main urban areas. You actually went out into the village because you felt that that's where the need was required more.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. From where you started and where it is now, can you just give us, in terms of numbers and what you've achieved so far with the foundation, how have the milestones panned out for you?
So my greatest achievement in the charity is having 456 kids.
Wow.
As at now.
Wow.
As we are counting. And these children, we provide them with so many things. For the first time, they get a blanket.
Wow.
For the first time, they get shoes. And that's I make sure that if they're 50 or they're 60 and we have all these uniforms, I tell my team to rest, and I want to clothe the kids.
Okay.
I want to make them feel that they are human. And because that's how I get in touch with my passion as well.
Okay.
So I for the first time, they get this new uniform, and I'm there putting new shoes on their feet. And sometimes we cry with the kids.
I'd imagine because, you would.
Yeah,
it's quite emotional.
I cry a lot with the kids, and some kids cry back because they also understand.
Oh.
Those that are a bit older, they would cry with me as well. So we have all these kids, and we've achieved quite a lot, quite a lot.
I agree with you. If you're talking about 435 children, you've dished out more than 15,000 blankets, you need a team around you.
Mm-hmm.
How have you gone about bringing on collaborations to support the foundation? Because I'm sure it's not something that you do alone.
Yes.
Okay.
Actually, we have a lot of volunteers across the country.
Fantastic.
We have volunteers that would help us with accounts that is difficult sometimes. And we have volunteers that would help us with technical issues, the media,
yeah,
our Facebook pages. And it's inculcating passion in the young people of this country to volunteer.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you volunteer, that's where you get your gift. That's why if you volunteer in a mechanical company, I've seen this with my brother.
Yeah.
He used to do that. And now he's doing mechanical engineering in Russia. And he's if he comes back home, he's like the most popular mechanic. It's the ability to volunteer.
Yeah.
And that's what we are trying to do as a charity as well, to help young people to understand that you need to volunteer before you can actually feel that you are ready to do something for yourself.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Because a lot of times I think that people feel that they need resources, mm-hmm. or they need a paid job in order to achieve something that is specifically their gift. I know that this gift has actually taken you to very high places. Yes. There is a saying that talks about your gift taking you before kings. Mm-hmm. You've literally met the queen.
Yes, I have.
I want to hear more about that. But for now, let's take a short break. And when we come back, big news with Buumba meeting Queen Elizabeth II. Stay with us. Welcome back. You are watching Life with Roses. On set today, I've got Buumba Malambo. And just before the break, we had the big news where she actually met Queen Elizabeth. It's often said that your gift can actually take you before kings. You have literally met the current Queen of England, Queen Elizabeth II.
Yes.
Do you want to tell us more about that experience?
Well, I always look for opportunities.
Okay.
And so my friend sent me this link and I looked at it, Queen Elizabeth meeting young people. I said, wow. Then I applied for it and it was intense.
Because why was she looking for young people? Sorry to
Okay,
jump
so
in
it was the Queen Young Leaders panel.
Okay.
Young people that are extremely exceptional okay. in the Commonwealth.
Okay.
So they only wanted 10 young people that would assess a lot of applications.
Okay.
For those between 15 up to 20 that would apply and get the award.
Okay.
So we were kind of the panel, the judges. We actually chose those who would get the awards to meet the Queen.
And what was the criteria that they were using to select you, the panel?
They were using experience.
Okay.
Being exceptional in your gifts.
Mm-hmm.
What you have done for your community,
okay.
not internationally, but for your community.
Mm-hmm.
And, well, I was found guilty and I was picked. Yeah.
So what did you specifically highlight out of what you had done in order to meet that criteria and become one of the 10?
It was working with the children in my country.
Okay.
Not the traveling that I've been doing over the years, not the trainings, not the awards. It was me doing something for my country even when I had limited resources.
Mm.
Knowing that it's my country, it's about being a citizen
okay.
and giving back.
Yeah.
And not sitting and complaining. And that's what they were looking for. And then they found it with me. And so I was the first Zambian, and we had all these other young people from the Commonwealth. And we met there and we assessed the applications and we picked the very best. It was intense. It was difficult because we had a lot of these young people that would want to meet the Queen.
I'd imagine
so. Yeah. And then we were called back. They just sent over the air tickets that you have to come and see the ones that will be awarded. And we even got the front seats. It was really amazing. And one of the highlights is when we were entering the gates
yeah.
Of Buckingham Palace.
Wow.
Because most people there, they're British, they're born there, and they'll never see the Queen. They've never seen the Queen. And they're always there from morning, starting from 6 a.m. They're there.
They've never seen her.
They've never seen her. It's really difficult to meet her.
Okay.
And they just saw this African girl going in the gate. And they were clapping for us. They were clapping for us. And for me, that was the highlight. And then I realized I was riding on the shoulders of giants.
Fantastic.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's literally having tea with the Queen.
Yes.
Follow up from that. Do you feel that that experience has enlightened you more in terms of how you manage the foundation going forward?
It has enlightened me more because now I know how to manage the charity in terms of management.
Okay.
In terms, because they also trained us in those things. They were training us to also train other people. So we're not just doing applications, they're also training us how to manage your projects. So I learned those things and I enhanced my brand because I realized that the Queen took so long to talk to me. than she did for everybody, even, mm-hmm. you know, like the prime minister, just greeting them and passing. But she wanted to know why I was dressed like that. She wanted to know which country I was from. So it reminded me, if you have a brand, you have to protect your brand. And then I went forward. Then I realized I also have a brand.
Good for you. So you represented Zambia well.
That's right.
Oh, that you have actually got 12 international awards.
Yes.
And 2 local Zambian awards.
Yes.
Do you want to just tell us a little bit about those achievements without sounding like you're bragging?
Well, my first award was Voice of Youth Africa.
Okay.
Because they just identified what I do. And they said, we've never come across a young person, especially in Africa, who would want to give back to the community when we always want to take. It's kind of something that is in Africa anyway. But then they realized that, well, in Zambia, there's these girls doing this. Then they called me. I was there in Nigeria getting the award. That was my first award.
Okay.
And my recent one was the Zambia Women of the Year Awards.
Mm-hmm.
I won the award in the activist category. So I have 2 local awards so far. So good. And I feel good because my own people are recognizing me. It's not easy to have your own people recognize you. Like they say, well, the prophet has no honor in their own house. So it's been overwhelming. And I feel special. I feel appreciated.
I was going to ask you how do those awards make you feel? Do you suddenly feel that you've done it all, you've arrived, or is there still more to come?
It's an indication.
It's an indication.
Of what is to come.
Okay.
And because I'm a loner person, I kind of listen to myself so much.
Okay.
So when I get all these things, I know there's something bigger coming. So I realize there's something big coming for me. And I know it. I've now
realized it. Hold that thought. We want to know more about Buumba on a personal capacity, just wanting to know about this loner and anything else that she does in her private life. We'll be right back. An amazing time speaking to Buumba Malambo, founder of the BuumbaLambo Foundation. Before the break, we were just going to go into getting to know this 20-something-year-old special woman. What is it that you do in your quiet time?
Well, in my quiet time, I don't really think I have a lot of quiet time.
Okay.
But if I do, I read a lot. I read a lot. I read a lot of bios for women, especially. Okay. Women that are politicians, that run companies. That's what I do actually mostly on the internet, and I'll be looking for all these people. And
you've got a passion for women as well?
Yes, okay. Very much. And okay. Because I get a certain trait from these women, they are not just women, they are special women. So they must have that special thing that I look for when I'm reading all their bios. So I read all these books. I love politics. So I read a lot of political books.
Okay.
My current book is about Kwame Nkrumah. That's what I'm reading. And William Wilberforce, the one who was helping abolish the slave trade. So I'm getting...
That's deep.
Yes.
That's very, very deep. But then a beautiful young lady like you, surely you've got somebody whispering in your ear. Any plans, relationship, anything we want to know about?
Well, yes, I do have somebody.
Great.
Who is really awesome. And keeps pushing me to work harder.
Okay.
And also on the quiet side, which I really like. So, yeah.
We're going to look for that space. We will be invited to your wedding, right?
Of course.
We would love to come.
When I decide to get married, you will know about it.
Okay, great. We've got a tradition on the show, which we say is Pass the Rose. Mm-hmm. You've shared your inspirational journey with us today. We really appreciate that and definitely applaud you for all the achievements that you've had so far.
Thank you.
So I'm going to give you a single rose and I'd like you to pass it on. Think about a person that you feel has got a dream or a purpose and a gift that they have not discovered yet. I'd like you to take that rose, speak to that person and dare them to bloom where they're planted. Will you do that for us?
Yes.
Here we go. Let's go. So here's a rose for you. Tell us who you're nominating and why.
I am nominating Aki Mwale, okay. My best friend, because his journey inspires me. And he reminds me of my struggle. And I know he's trying to get his dream together. And that's what I love about him, because he's trying and he's working hard. His family is also helping him.
Wow.
And that's why I'm passing this rose to you, Akim, that you can do it. Like I always tell you, there's nothing impossible with God.
Yeah. So Akim, grab this rose, take it on, and we're looking forward to meeting you on set with your dream.
Yeah.
Any closing advice that you have for people that would also like to achieve their dreams, apart from Akim, what advice do you have for others who would really like to just walk a journey of impacting others?
Well, Lupita Nyong'o says, wherever you are, in your single corner, remember that your dreams are valid.
That's right.
And my current book that I'm reading about William Wilberforce, he says it is better to die knowing yourself than to die people knowing about you. So you have to know yourself, you have to know your passion, you have to know your journey. That really helps.
Yes.
And know that your dreams are valid.
Wow. Thank you so much, Buumba. It has been an absolute pleasure and a thrill to have you with me today. Thank you for taking your time.
Thank you so much.
Speaking to me. I absolutely love that smile, by the way. There you go, folks. You're never too young, you're never too old. Go for that dream. Go and inspire somebody else. Bloom where you're planted. This has been Life is Roses. This is Rose Sibisi signing off. Until next time.